Welcome to this Made for Success audio program. The audio you are listening to is designed to turn your potential into performance, succeed in every area of your life, and achieve your dreams. Now sit back and relax as our featured speaker begins.
Hey everyone, this is Celebrate Calm founder Kirk Martin, and I'm here with my son Casey coming to you live from La Jolla, California. Listen, there's no way you could possibly be defiant in La Jolla unless someone tells you to leave, because it is beautiful here. If you are a weatherman, the only thing you have to know to say is this: it's going to be sunny and 73 tomorrow. So listen, we're thrilled you're here with us as we discover 10 ways to stop defiance and disrespect. And if you're like me, you have kids who excel at arguing and pushing your buttons. And there's nothing that creates such a visceral reaction from parents than defiance and disrespect from our kids, because we would have never said that to our parents. It causes us to feel like a failure, because obviously we must be doing something wrong or our kids wouldn't talk back like they do. We have anxiety because we fear for our children. If they actually make it out of childhood, who is going to hire them or marry them with that kind of mouth? And then there's the embarrassment. What will our friends, teachers, our own parents think about our kids and us? So this causes parents to react emotionally, causes us to inflame situations and create these explosive households in which everyone is on edge, just waiting for the next explosion, either from the child or the parent. Now, I want to posit a very contrarian thought to frame this entire discussion. See, as parents, we often dread the power struggles and we fear the teenage years. But many kids don't even wait until the teenage years. They have highly developed mouths by the age of 2. But instead of dreading these interactions, I want you to see them as huge opportunities, as an opportunity to teach your kids a different way to deal with their frustration and anger, as an opportunity to enhance your authority, build your relationship with your kids, and teach them powerful life skills. I want to show you what I mean with a pretty edgy real-life example to demonstrate this, and I hope you're not offended. So Casey's going to help me out with this one.
Question: what do you do when a teenager is disrespectful and uses foul language?
So I'm working with this good Midwestern family, and a dad has 2 daughters, but he prefers one daughter because they're a lot alike, and the other daughter is a little different. She's kind of odd, like many of our kids. And the girl knows that her dad prefers her sister. So one night at dinner, when this girl resists doing a chore, the father says, "Your sister never gives me trouble." So this girl looks her father right in the eyes and drops the F-bomb right to his face. "F you, Dad." Now, what do you do in that situation? Now, I don't want you to say, "Honey, thank you for expressing your emotions and feelings so vividly." No way. You'd probably react the way the father did. "Young lady, you will not ever talk to me like that. To your room now. All your privileges are revoked and you're grounded for a month." Now, that makes sense to me, and there's nothing wrong with that. Only it won't teach her anything or get to the root of the issue. This was a huge missed opportunity for the dad, and it will have repercussions throughout this girl's teenage years and life.
Now, is there any justification or excuse for what the daughter said? Never. But here's the missed opportunity. What if the father had said this?
"Honey, I know that you know using that language in my home is unacceptable. I also know that you know the consequences for using that language are extremely severe." And yet you say.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.